guys, welcome to Florida Keys Life. I want to give you the walkthrough that I've mentioned of our 2023 Stingray 273 center console. We're going to go compartment by compartment, show you all the uses and the things that we have in those compartments, and we're going to talk about the different uses for the boat and the reasons why we bought the boat. So we're going to start in the bow, where the anchor's at, and we'll take you along with us. Okay, so first, up here in the front, we have an anchor compartment and a windlass. So our previous boats didn't have that. It's very beneficial and makes anchoring much easier. We're actually anchored right now. So we have a Lumar windlass up here. We actually keep a dock line up here for anchoring up on buoy lines. But it has a nice anchor ready to go. Switches are all right here, easy to use. There's also a switch at the helm that you can use. And the bonus thing that we've got here is a freshwater washdown with a hose. And so not only is this hose long enough to clean your anchor and any dirt you might accumulate up here, but the entire bow of the boat, we've got a freshwater washdown on the rear deck we'll show you, but then there's one in the bow as well. Okay, so then up here in the bow seating area, and again, I'm gonna show this in two different modes, in kind of family sandbar mode, and then in fishing mode, which I have the cushions out right now in fishing mode, so we'll talk about that. But we have two insulated storage compartments up here that can be coolers. We keep this one with coolers and drinks and ice in this one for food and eating, so it can be separate from all your fishing stuff in the back. And then this box over here we use for dry storage, but it could be a cooler. We put all of our extra dock lines and life jackets in here. We have six life jackets in here. We have more back by the battery, so we can show you how we do that. But that could be a cooler if you need it, or it could even be fish boxes if you're on extended use. Now, one thing I want to talk about too is these latches. These latches are really awesome. I know they're in several different boats. It's not exclusive to Stingray, but that's the latch mode. But then if you're in and out of a hatch a lot, you put it on the red mode, it's not latched. And so it's much easier to access that way. Also up here in the bow, we have cup holders on both sides, courtesy lighting, and phone chargers in 12 volt. You have the regular card port, and then you have USB ports on both sides. Also, I forgot to mention, up in the anchor, you have access to your road and chain, so in case there's any clogs up when you're anchoring, you can pull that up through and out through to make that job much easier. Now also, we're going to show you here, when we get to family mode, this is where your table support goes, right here. So we're going to show you, there's actually, you can put the cushion in right here, or the filler, the table piece sits right here, or it's actually out and it's holder in the head compartment right now, but you can lay down or use this as a full lounging facility, or as a table, or completely out like it is now. Okay, turning around to the lounger, we have here this huge lounging area with a great storage. I'm told this is also insulated. I've never used it as an actual cooler. I use it for dry storage now, but we're going to show you how they actually send you with an angle cooler with Stingray emblems on it. That's a really thick, good cooler for long-term storage of ice. But in dry mode, this is what we've got. So we put all our dive gear in this box. It is a drained compartment. It has a nice drain in the corner. Well, you can't see it, but it's in that back corner. It has lighting in here, and it is insulated. But we use it for dry storage. So we'll show you this in cooler mode. And there we go, cooler mode. So it's a nice angle cooler. It actually says Stingray Boats on it, so it's nice. They give you these nice straps with cleats to hold it down. So you've got some really long-term ice storage here. Our plan, if we were on long trips, is we just fill that up with ice and use it into our different coolers in the deal. But you could leave it in there, and it just cuts your rest of your dry storage down a bit. So we don't keep it in there very often, but on long trips. But that's how that looks. Okay. Before we get all the way to the back here too, we got some extra cup holders with some nice Corian accents, speakers, and more lighting. At nighttime, this, when you put the courtesy lights on, this thing is well lit up. So as we start moving back to the console, this is one of the main reasons why we chose this boat. It's 27 feet 11 inch overall, basically a 28 foot boat, but a head compartment like this is unheard of in this size of boat. So it's got a nice latch to keep it aerated, nice talk.
Okay, so you get a full sink with a countertop, and you got a ton of storage underneath that, essentially head vanity underneath there. We got a lot of dry storage I'll show you in there. We got a porcelain head with a self-contained compartment that's fresh water only, so you don't get the smell of the seawater. You got your Fusion amp, and you got your Fusion head unit here, which everything's run through the Garmin unit. I'll show you that. That's why the head unit can be down here. And this is your access to your electronics. Gives you good access, pops right out. Another important feature you'll see is that this is your table. So Stingray was thinking ahead that it's got a nice set of brackets here on either side and a nice latch to latch it up there to keep this thing secure while you're underway. We'll take that out and show you in table mode here in just a second. But in here, you can see this compartment goes all the way up under the lounger storage up into there. So there's lots of storage. We keep all our extra stuff, sandbar stuff, extra buoys, extra fishing gear, all that stuff, all under there. Okay, coming back around here to the helm is where they really did some good thought. So we got a three-sided enclosure up here, really nice. This helm pad comes with it for extra phone and goodie storage. It had this cutout in the recess for a compass. I've added that. We'll talk about the add-ons and stuff since. But we got two 12-inch Garmin screens that came with the boat. I think standard is just one screen, but our particular option list had the two. Now, important thing that they're doing, standard feature, is Garmin's digital switching system. Which gives you all your switch access in one screen. So as you see this dash, it's pretty uncluttered. You don't have to have switches here or switches there. We have them right here on the screen. And as a redundancy backup, behind the gate dash panel in there is the control box for this, and you can manually move a fuse one slot down. It shows you where to do it, and you can manually turn on any of these circuits in case this whole system dies for some reason. You got your magnetic charger, cell phone charger right here. Your phone clips right in. Scan strut, pretty standard on a lot of boats these days. Suzuki controls, your windlass control, and zip wake. It's another standard option on this thing, which when we're running the boat, we'll try to show you, but it's great. You can walk around side to side on this boat, and it levels itself back out pretty dang quickly. We've got the premium Suzuki controls, which are great and easy to use. Got these controls in the Suzuki switch, but very clean, neat control panel. We got grab handles on either side. We got our Garmin VHF overhead. Another storage compartment, which really nice, as you'll see throughout the boat, a lot of Stingray accents, really nice. And you got this overhead grab handle, which is a great feature that a lot of boats this size don't have. You got your map lighting, speakers, the sound system on this boat is great. Cup holders on either side for the captain. Got a nice lockable glove compartment and another open compartment with, if you can see over here, with more cell phone chargers. So as everybody's on the boat, they want to secure the cell phone or whatever sort of electronic device they have, they can put it in there, charge it in there, skipper's phone goes there. Dual level footrest. So if you're standing up and using that, that works great. If you're sitting at the helm, you've got one that's a little higher. So coming back here to the captain's chairs, we have dual captain's chairs that operate the same. The nice armrest here, and it locks, so it doesn't just flop around all over the place. It's got a little push button to open it back up. With the adjustable bolsters, you can actually sit in this position if you want better visibility for short folks. Sit right here. You have the regular chair that folds out nice, and they actually slide back and forth on there, so when you can get a little closer to the helm if you need to. Very comfortable helms, very nice stitching. As you see, Stingray does a great job there. And moving right below the console, the helm seats here, you have your battery switches, which has your automatic combiners. You can combine both your house batteries, or you can combine both your engine battery, your engine to your start battery, your engine to your house batteries, and then combine both your engine start batteries there. You got your fuses for your switches and your main fuses for your big stuff right here. And underneath here, we have access to the battery compartment underneath that we store all our screen covers. You see the batteries back here. That's a whole nother video we'll talk about, but I got more life jackets and all of our required safety equipment underneath here. Really nice compartment that stays dry and easy to access. Moving along to the port side of the captain's console here, we have a garbage can. Hardly any manufacturers we looked of, especially in this size, thought about what to do with the garbage. It's an important thing. It's got a nice little garbage can here with a closeout deal. We go around to the other side of the helm station, and we've got our tackle center. One of the tackle centers anyway. So you got your pliers, knives, scissors, couple of Plano boxes. Those are the 3600 Plano boxes, and another little storage shelf up there. And then this other tackle station on the back above the rear live well. So these are actually the 3400 series Plano boxes that fit really nice and organize and allow you to store all your tackle and things that you would need with some little extra space right there. Okay, Stingray was really thinking back here. So we have actually three washdown outlets out here. We have raw water over here on this side. We have raw water in this nice hosed compartment right here that they provide for you standard that keeps it nice and secured right there. And then we have fresh water over here on this side. They give you a 19 gallon fresh water tank. And so I almost exclusively, when I'm out and about, use fresh water. Okay, in addition to your fresh water washdown right here, they also give you a nice shower off hose fitting here. When you're getting on and off the swim step or you're diving or whatnot, you can wash yourself off with fresh water right there. Now back here in the cockpit, they were really thinking about what you need on the water on a hot day. You always need a drink. So you have one, these are the rod holder, cup holder combos with cup holder right here. So that's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 cup holders just here in the rear cockpit, and all nicely placed throughout the boat as well. For the fishing side of things, we have the two live wells. So we have a 30 gallon live well right here, circular style, very adjustable, run by huge Pentair pumps, works great, very well placed. And then you have the larger live well right here that you could also use as a cooler if you want, but I've used it as a live well. It works great. Same type of pump, same adjustments. It actually kept fish alive overnight very easily. So now let's take a look at the hatches. So over here on this side, we have two huge fish storage boxes on both port and starboard, and they go actually up to about the back of the cabin. They're a long ways up there. So I use this one for dry storage. This is the rear shade. We'll show you with that up here in a minute. I just keep it there because it's a really long storage compartment for that. And then over here on the port side, it's the same hatch compartment. That's primarily what I use for fish, is over on this side. It's nice, easy to get the fish in and out of. As you see, in the rear cockpit here, they give you a very nice gutter system. So it came around the fish boxes and it goes around the transom to your overport scupper drains there that have check valves in them to keep them to keep your deck nice and dry, which you're actually walking on. Works very good. Here in the rear, you also have nice folding cleats that retract away all around the boat. So then looking at the back of the console, this is one of the other big things that was a plus for us, is this heavy rear supported console cover. So this is very heavy frame system, to where if you see here the kingfish rod holders, which I use for wahoo trolling and everything else, they're welded connected to the whole frame assembly. Other manufacturers I'd look at, just put your kingfish rod holder right through the fiberglass in the corner of the hardtop. Not super strong. This, super strong. Very well built and well done by Stingray. Okay, as we look over on the side, you have rod storage for three rods on each side of the gunwale. They also give you a nice tow rail, so if you're fighting a fish over the side,
You can hook your toes in there and it gives you that leverage so you don't worry about going over. The other important thing to realize is the gunwale height on this boat is higher than most all the boats we looked at. It's very safe for kids and families, very comfortable for fishing. So as you can see, I'm 5'9", and it hits me not at waist height, but about upper thigh, mid thigh area. Very comfortable, especially when you're in rough water and stuff and you run up against the bolster. Very comfortable, very nice padding, very well designed. Okay, as we go back on the transom here, we have, in addition to the cup holders we talked about and the shower wash down, you can put four rods along here. This is actually for a ski tow deal that we don't have, don't need it. Not super excited about it, but they offer that option. You also have great access to your rear bilge right here, all nice and open. Those are your big Pentair live well pumps for keeping your bait alive. Fuel water separators, easy to access. There's your water tank, fuel tanks right here. A lot of your wiring and stuff is great access, great large bilge compartment. Okay, now as we come back onto the swim step here, we have a nice tuna or docking door right here on the back, and it leads straight in from a nice boarding ladder. So for swimming and diving, this is a great feature. You just toss it in overboard. Now, one of the things that some other manufacturers, they didn't think about is when that's being used or when it's out, how you can walk in it. So Stingray really thought ahead by having this cover on it and even filling in the center area so that it's comfortable to walk on, and it's straight through the tuner door, docking door, so it gives easy access from the water into the boat. So you have access to your stereo right here, so when you're in the water at the sandbar, you got easy access right there. You got a grab handle to come back in the boat. And then here's the main thing about this boat and this swim step, is that I couldn't find hardly any boats this size that have a swim step with this great access. So aside from the ladder on that side, you can hoist yourself pretty easily into the boat right here. And so you're not always having a traffic jam at one swim ladder or one access. And then you have this walkway area, that you have about 10, 12 inches between the transom and the recess to that well to be able to walk side to side. So for getting on and off this boat, really easy. We were concerned about not having a docking door or a tuna door on the side of the hull, but this gives us great access from either side of the boat, from the dock and from the water. And the main thing that made that difference is taking the rigging and taking it up through this well instead of taking it off the transom like most everybody else. Then you get access right here to that rear part of the bilge that accesses your bilge pump and other rigging if you need to work on it. Two pretty good accesses right there. And then right here, you'd normally think, so these are Suzuki 200s. They're big four cylinders. For a boat this size, seems underpowered. When we first saw this boat at the Fort Lauderdale Boat Show, we actually saw the 25-foot version. It had 150s on it, and I said to the guy, 150s on a 25, that kind of makes it a dog. I said, oh no, that's all the power this boat needs. I was hesitant, so I looked up the performance data on this boat. They only showed what they call the 269 DC, but in further research I found that that boat is the same hull as this boat. And they had the performance numbers on there that with 200 Suzukis, it got 2.7 miles to the gallon at 30 miles an hour. And that's unheard of. I went through hundreds of performance reports in boats this size, and I could not replicate those numbers. So I found a dealer that had one of these in stocks. It was Santa Sea Marine up in Stuart, Florida. And I asked them if I could come up and sea trial the boat shortly after the boat show. And they put it in the water and did. I was hesitant. I was thinking it needed 250s or 300s even. To really run to push this boat the way that it should. But the Z-plane hull design makes all the difference in this boat. And with these 200s, we sea trialed the boat, and in the conditions we had with little to nothing on the boat, we actually got 2.8 at 30 miles to the gallon, which is crazy. And I'm going to show you on this boat, even today, we're going to get 2.7, and I've got several documented times of me running it. I'll insert the video here. With all my gear on it and more fuel and everything else, still getting 2.7, maybe 2.6 at 30 miles an hour. This is the beautiful part of this boat. 29 miles an hour coming in. 2.7 miles to the gallon. All right, 30, actually 30 miles an hour for me is where I want to be. I don't need to be running around at 60 miles an hour. That's a comfortable run on the boat, and this boat really makes it work. And these particular engines, I'm kind of more of a Mercury fan with kind of Yamaha second. I wasn't really considering Suzuki. However, these motors, when we went to Sea Trial, were so quiet. They have such a high torque, it popped this boat up on plane so quick and pushed this boat so well. I've been very happy with these Suzuki 200s on the back of this boat. They've done really well. You think about a 28-foot boat with 200s on it, seems like it'd be a dog. This hull makes all the difference. The Z-plane, what it does, instead of having strakes that come off the bottom of the hull that create air bubbles and create lift, technically, it sends air bubbles back to the props under that scenario. This particular hull has graduations and steps in the hull rather than strakes. And because of that, it doesn't create air bubbles to send dirty water back to the props. It sends clean, unaerated water, which gives better grip. It's kind of like your car driving on a gravel road versus driving on concrete. It's the same thing, and that's why you can take a boat that might seem like it's a little underpowered, and it does so great and performs so well fuel efficient wise. This boat is really an overlooked, undermarketed boat for what it's doing. I've got over 30 hours on this boat now, and I can guarantee you that under normal conditions, 30 miles an hour, you'll get 2.6 to 2.8 miles to the gallon on a regular basis. And what that does is we have 165 gallons of fuel on this boat. So when you do the math, it increases your range. It lets you fish in and out of here with using a lot less fuel. It makes it a lot more affordable to be on the water. Might let you go a lot more places. Okay, before we put the table up, so this is in family sandbar mode. This is actually where I keep it most of the time because I fish by myself and it's 80% of the time I'm not really up here. So I usually keep the cushions right here so it's ready to go on family stuff. So I want to show you the cooler access. They have a great design for cushions here that has the hinge up access, so it's easy to get in and out of these compartments. Super easy with that folding hatch. And then the backrests, as you see, very comfortable permanent backrests. So
out a little bit further too, so it's,
yeah, they give you a little bit more support there. A lot of the boats have removable headrests or that hinge out or do different things. These ones are always there ready to go. When there's no cushions here though, before, like I showed you, there's plenty of platform there to be casting or fishing from if you want to up here. And then this is even a pretty big platform right here. As we roll into the lounger section here, you see, forgot to mention the nice armrests that are here, very comfortable lounger area. Again, with a yacht certified boat, you can have a ton of people on this boat and still be comfortable. Okay, so first off, to show it in flat mode for lounging, so we got this nice little base. I love how heavy duty this is. I know there's lots of other folding systems, but I kind of like the mechanical setup, because to be quite honest, you don't use the table very often. So when you take this out, it's essentially non-existent. Table, you notice that you have these nice latches. They go in female recesses on there. And so this just sits right on that support. Right on the support. Put the latches out. And then it's a flat platform. You could stand on this if you wanted to just be fishing up here and have the cushions out. You could still have this complete flat platform there, and then it gives you a full cushion arrangement for the front. Now I'm 5'9". This was one of the tests I wanted to see on the boat. We go camping down at the Dry Tortugas. I can lay right here. And if your wife's a little shorter, you can lay here beside you. But you can't actually do it. Now let's put it into a table mode. Like I say, we don't use a table very often, but when we're camping, it's nearly invaluable. And pretty much like an RV, you've got a nice table here. So, like I say, not usable for fishing or sandbar mode, but camping, it's invaluable. And the beautiful thing is Stingray gives you the storage compartment for this. I've seen several other boats that there's not a real good plan for what to do with this table assembly. Okay, now moving back into the rear of the boat. So when you're in sandbar mode or you have lots of guests on the boat, you've got that seat that folds out, three adults, pretty comfortable. And then you have this nice cushion that sits right here. You can sit 5 to 6 people comfortably here.
Yeah, so our legs don't even...
In the rear cockpit. There's how close your legs are. Very comfortable ride back here. It's the other thing I talked about, the Z-plane hull and the efficiency, is it sits down in the water very nicely. And my wife and I have actually been on the water when it was 3-foot seas out, and we were sitting in the helm seat and comfortable at 30 miles an hour. That's hard to find. Okay, and one caveat I forgot to mention. We are not paid by Stingray. I don't work for Stingray. I have anything to do with Stingray, but this boat really fits our needs, and I think our need is pretty common down here, especially in the Keys. And I think this boat is under marketed. Like, I didn't know what it was. I stumbled across, they had a couple of dual console boats, and they had one center console, their 25, at the Fort Lauderdale show. And when I started asking more questions, they were just, oh wait, we have a 27 as well. So then I did a bunch of research. There's very little on the internet about this boat. And so I think this boat is a big deal. And so that's why I want to tell you about it, because I've used it now some. It does exactly what I wanted it to do, and I'm really excited about the boat.